After reading Bill Gates' latest book, How to Avoid a Climate Disaster, and having noted that Vaclav's name came up throughout it, and having recently seen Bill Gates is quoted as saying, "There is no author whose books I look forward to more than Vaclav Smil," I decided to pick up some of his work. Now, this is one of those books that just covers a lot of really interesting information. I didn't really have a clear purpose or intent behind reading this book, but it just covers a lot of interesting ideas and information that, as the subtitle suggests, help us better understand the world that we live in. And so it covers a whole wide range of interesting themes, including things like life expectancy, what makes people happy, China's future, impactful inventions, climate change, and many, many other interesting ideas. Now, some of my favorite takeaways from the book include, number one, discovering some of the challenges that China has coming up, including the fact that they have an aging population and not enough young people entering the workforce and things like that over the coming decades. And a lot of this is actually due to their former one-child policy and some of the unintended negative consequences that resulted from that policy. Number two, why certain kinds of innovation take far more time than expected, specifically the kinds of innovations that aren't necessarily tied to the rapid advancement of technology. And in some cases, there are innovations that you would think are tied to the rapid pace of increased performance of computers and things like that, things like Moore's Law. And yet, even though that may in fact be true, it's things like human nature and human behavior and our tendency to kind of adopt things more slowly that often hold back certain inventions or innovations. And number three, some of the real challenges around the transition from coal or gas-powered equipment to electric-powered alternatives. And some of the major issues here really revolve around battery capacity and the weight of batteries. So in certain situations, such as semi-truck, or cargo ships, or even things like airplanes, electric power may in fact be a really practical solution, except for the fact that battery capacity either isn't high enough or the weight of those batteries really kind of offset the gains of trying to transition over to electricity. Now, I will say there was a considerable amount of overlap between this book and Bill Gates' book on how to avoid a climate disaster, and that's pretty understandable because, again, Bill Gates reads Vaclav's work and was heavily inspired by it. And so with that said, for me personally, one thing I do wish is that I didn't read these books almost entirely back to back. It would have been probably better to space them out so that I can enjoy one book and then kind of revisit some of the ideas and explore similar ideas maybe a few weeks or more likely a few months later. And so if you're interested in both books, I would recommend probably spacing them out over several months. And I find that's a really practical way to not only revisit certain information and to kind of reinforce it in the mind, but also to get a different perspective. Because even though it might have, you know, similar ideas being discussed in two different books, oftentimes getting a different person's perspective can allow the idea to kind of settle in a different way. So I wish I had done that. I didn't do that. Still enjoyed the book. It does cover a lot that isn't covered in Bill Gates' book, of course. So if, like me, you're interested in interesting information that help us better understand the modern world and you just like exploring interesting facts and information, consider reading Numbers Don't Lie by Vaclav Smil.